Hey everybody, it's Engineer It, and I have some really, really exciting stuff to share with you today. So, there's been a lot of really exciting news going on in Star Wars lately. Specifically, Galaxy's Edge just opened in Disneyland, and I'm really excited to go visit this. I know it's been one of my dreams to go visit this park. So in the meantime, while I'm waiting to go to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, because it's going to probably be so busy, it's going to be almost impossible to do anything there, I decided to start a new robotics project. So what I'm going to be doing is I'll be developing a fully autonomous R2 unit, which will be using a machine learning algorithm with TensorFlow by Google. In addition to this, I'm also going to be incorporating my old PC components from this guy right here and incorporating all that into my R2 unit. So not only will this R2 unit be able to drive around and interact with people at conventions and public spaces, but it also will serve as a critical gaming battle station when I go to LAN parties or even just on the go. So it'd be a kind of a really cool, like, mix-match sort of R2 unit.
That little droid and I have been through a lot together. You okay, R2?
One really unique aspect of this R2 unit is that it'll be almost entirely 3D printed. A lot of my inspiration for this robotics project started looking at XRobots by James Bruton. If you look in the description below, you'll see a link to an R2 project that he did that was entirely 3D printed. So for my R2 project, I'm also going to make everything entirely 3D printed. The purpose of this video is I'm just going to talk a little bit about kind of the plan of attack that I'm going to do to develop this R2 unit, and just kind of briefly talk about what I've done so far. For most of the modeling, I'll be using SolidWorks right over here, which is not free to use, but you can get a free trial version if you would like. You could also use Autodesk Fusion, Autodesk Inventor, or even Creo Parametric. And there's a vast variety of other types of parametric software out there, but this is primarily a 3D modeling tool that a lot of different engineers use and developing pretty much anything you could imagine. So once I've finished developing most of my models in SolidWorks and getting a rough idea of what the design will look like, I'll then take those designs and I'll throw them onto my 3D printer. Once the parts for each subsystem are 3D printed, I'll then take those components, mate them together with various epoxies and glues, and then actually mount that to the main structure of the R2 unit. As I'm assembling this R2 unit together, any sort of weird anomalies that I come across as I'm putting everything together, I can make those necessary adjustments in my SolidWorks model here, and then from there, I can continue to develop and print new 3D models as I kind of go along, so I won't have any sort of unnecessary gaps going on with this project. Let's go ahead and swap over to this model here, and I'm just going to show you today the basic frame structure that I put together for both his body and his head. Okay, so this is the dome and the body frame assembly for R2. So I have it divide up into four distinct parts. So I have this front frame assembly right here, I have the rear frame assembly, I have the skirt assembly, which is this guy down below, so if I highlight it, this is how big it is, and I have the dome assembly, which is basically the head. So for this design of the frame structure, what I did was I went on to astromech.net, which is the R2 Builder's website, and there they have blueprints for all different types of R2 units. So I took those values and I basically created this 1-inch structural frame for the robot. That way I'll be able to create relatively straightforward models to 3D print, and additionally I'll be able to take those models and create a really structurally sound piece that will hold true. So now that I have the entire model put together like this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take little sections of each one of these frame pieces and divide up into small little sections by looking at these intersections here and just making little split lines. With that, I'll be able to fit it into my 3D printer and hopefully be able to get all these parts printed at a reasonable time. So let's go ahead and throw all this stuff on the printer and see what comes out the other end. When the jobbers run the shop in your neighborhood, think you can cook, I got a grappling hook. Let's make this quick, cause I'm really booked. I'm a devious degenerate defender of the devil, shunting all the trash compactors on the detention level. My backpack's got chance, well I'm Boba, all the fat, well I bounty hunt for Jabba Hutt to finance my vet. Well I chill in deep space, a mask is over my face. Well I deliver the prize, but I still narrow my eyes, cause my time I don't like to waste. Get down! I'm a question, rep inside Enigma, get inside a slave one, find your home and signal for me. You know, it's a pretty nice day outside. You know, the wind's pretty nice, it's not too hot, not too cold, and the lighting's pretty good. So I decided, you know what, let's just do this all outside. So I went ahead and I just finished up printing out and assembling all of the stuff for the body frame and for the head frame. So let's go ahead and take a look real fast. All right, so this right here, this is the body frame all assembled for R2. So as you can see, it's kind of that
that 1-inch thick sort of structure that I was talking about. All the pieces were labeled and assembled. I basically used super glue to assemble most of this stuff. And if you look really closely here, let me see if I can get that in the camera. If you look really closely at kind of where those grooves are, I used a two-part epoxy kind of as a final finish piece to really mate the surfaces together to get all the 3D printed parts mated properly. And this last part here, I'm still working on this guy. This is the dome right here. So I haven't actually gotten to the epoxy yet, but you can kind of see there's already that dome, very famous dome shape of R2 there. Still trying to get a couple pieces glued together, still drying off a little bit. And this guy down here, this little X piece, that, as a matter of fact, is going to be part of the head turn assembly. So what's going to happen there is, you probably saw those four holes in there. As he rotates, that X frame, as it rotates, it'll basically move the wires kind of towards the outside as he turns left and right. And once he kind of moves back to center, the wiring will start moving back towards the center of the robot assembly. So the idea behind that is it's supposed to prevent any sort of tangling from occurring.
So that's all I had today for R2. I hope you all really enjoyed this episode. This is, a matter of fact, my first YouTube series that I've ever done. Was there something you liked? Was there something that you disliked? Was there something that maybe you want me to elaborate a little bit further upon? If so, please let me know in the comments section below. And I would like to make this as much of a two-way street between me and you as possible. And with that, thank you so much for checking out my video, and hopefully I'll see you on the next one. All right, everyone, have a great rest of your day, and stay frosty out there.